Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Today we will discuss the preparation of soluble salt method by method 2, and this method in which acid react with any soluble base alkali, or the acid react with the soluble carbonate. Now the procedure will be, we will measure the alkali with the pipette, and we will put it or pour it in the conical flask. Then the next step will be to add the indicator. We can use the phenolphthalein, which give it out the colors. The color change will tell that this whole process, the end point neutralization, or the methyl orange indicator. Then we add acid into the burette and note the starting volume. After this, by adding acid, indicator will change the color because we added the acid in the alkali. So after adding acid, it will change, it will give out the color. Then we will record the final volume of the acid, that how much acid is required to neutralize the base. Then add this volume of the acid into the same volume of alkali without indicator. Then we will heat till the saturation point and then allow the crystals to cool down and dry. This is the graphical representation of how we add alkali. This is with the phenolphthalein indicator, give out the pink color. But after the titration, like when we add the acid into it, after titration, it will give out the colorless solution, the final colorless solution. After this, heating will be done. And then the last process, we will remove the evaporating basin from heat and allow the filtrate to dry and crystallize. We will get the crystals of this soluble salt by the method in which both the reactants are soluble base or the soluble carbonates with acid. The next comes example. Magnesium carbonate react with HCl to form magnesium chloride and carbon dioxide and water, and any soluble base, sodium hydroxide, with HCl to form NaCl and water.